What's up, Lorehounds? Here outside the StarCraft World Championships going on, just getting kicked off. I'm here with Bruce and Nathan, the co-creators of Part and Parcel. So first, for our viewers, what is Part and Parcel and why did you create it in the first place?
So Blizzard was running a contest called Rock the Cabinet 2017. It's an annual contest that they run in order to encourage the creation of community content with the StarCraft II editor. This year's theme for the contest was to create a co-op mission playable by two players, and the grand prize of the winner of the contest would be your map goes into the game officially, get BlizzCon tickets, a dev jam, $10,000, and we won. And so now the developers have created a version of Part and Parcel inspired by our entry, and people are demoing it right here on the floor today.
Awesome. So, Nathan, how long did you guys spend on this bad boy? I mean, $10,000 is great, but if you spent, you know, 90 hours a week for 6 months, maybe not so much.
I'm reluctant to work out the math exactly on what my hourly wages would have been. I think we spent about 3 months actively working on the map, passing it back and forth, just kind of doing it old school where we would just give each other all the files at the end of the day. And so one of us would be working on it at a time. But yeah, I think it was about 3 months, 4 months of active work, and then probably about the same amount of time waiting to hear the results of the contest.
What was worse, working on it that much or just waiting?
Working on it was really fun, and waiting was really stressful, especially since there was a community vote portion of the contest. We felt really confident about our work, and we would stay up at night stressing about whether we'd make the top 10, which was Blizzard decided, but then the community was going to narrow it down to 5. And of course, there's no idea what the community is going to like. And, you know, we have our tastes as gamers, everyone else has theirs. Who knows what would happen? We made it by a margin of like 30 votes. We were the last one in the top 5.
Okay, well, I mean, you made it, and obviously it proved out for you guys. So how close do you feel their take on your map is?
We played it through once, and I gotta say, it looks great. I'm really happy that the art assets got created for it. I think it looks beautiful. It's very close to the original design. The original version featured custom voice acting by Nathan, which didn't make the cut because he's not Screen Actors Guild.
He's not a professional voice actor.
Wait,
was that really the reason? Because he's not Screen Actors Guild?
Correct. Yeah. They can't go scab. But I think it looks great. I really love it. I think it captures the spirit of the original, and it's easily recognizable as ours.
So you guys won. You spent a ton of time on this, a lot of stress, at least on the waiting part. Would you guys do it again?
Oh, absolutely. I think they do a Rock the Cabinet contest every year. The theme is different. I believe last year was more of like a custom arcade, kind of whatever style of freeform game you can make in the StarCraft II editor. So we'll have to see what next year's contest is. And since we entered under Bruce's name as Bus Wally, I'll just enter this one under my name as Keonius. And so they'll have no idea that we won the same contest twice.
Well, hacking the system there a little bit. All right, well, best of luck next year hiding under his name. And then I guess he'll get all the glory next year?
That's right.
That's my plan.
Thanks, guys.